When I first met Reverend Dr. V. Seymour Cole in the early 1980s, I never dreamed that one day he would become my pastor and that ultimately I would write a book about his life. I was attending a weekend retreat at Nyack College in Nyack, New York when I met him. Nyack is about 40 miles north of New York City. The college is well known for educating young pastors and missionaries, including Montrose Waite and other early black evangelicals. The weekend I was there, Pastor Cole was the keynote speaker. Leaders of the Christian Mission of the USA sponsored and hosted the event. As he delivered his sermons, I thought, he truly knows what's important to this congregation. He's addressing the right issues. I was impressed at how he had obviously done his homework on us before stepping up to speak. Instead of offering a boilerplate of platitudes, he actually delivered a thoughtful and poignant presentation that was full of relevant and useful information and God-inspired scripture. I thought, one of these days, I'll visit his church. Well, a few years later, that day came when I was asked to sing during a wedding ceremony at the Bronx Bethany Church of the Nazarene. Shortly thereafter, my family and I visited the church and later became members. The book, When God Calls, the Heart and Ministry of the Holiness Preacher, Reverend Dr. V. Seymour Cole, tells how Pastor Seymour and First Lady Dorothy Cole followed God on what became a miraculous journey. They learned to trust Him and stand on the promises of God despite the difficulties and hardships they faced. And there were many, believe me. For example, they came to the United States as immigrants from Jamaica during the height of the civil rights struggle and social revolution. They knew little about the subtleties of the cultures and the racial animosity here. It was also amazing how so few Americans knew anything about Jamaica beyond what they could read in a travel brochure. So the Coles faced a challenging and frequently difficult time of adjustment, yet they found their niche in the midst of a culturally and racially divided nation. This book also shows how their personal example of holy living has become a model for many couples and families as they seek to understand and then stand under God's call upon their lives. It's a revealing and moving story. Everybody will benefit from reading it.